The next rule we are going on to is
rule number 16.
Action by giveaway vessel. Can you read the rule, please?
Rule 16, action by giveaway vessel. Every vessel which is directed to keep out of the way of another vessel shall, so far as possible, take early and substantial action to keep well clear.
Nothing much in this rule. Actually, this is an addition to rule 8. There is not much here. It just says, only thing is, here he is separating out that if you are the giveaway vessel, you should take early and substantial action to keep well clear. We have already spoken about substantial actions when we say 30 degrees, 40 degrees. Rule 8 talks of readily apparent, right? So I won't take much of your time on rule 16, but if you refer to my video on rule 8, that will give you entire clarity of what is expected of the giveaway vessel, right? In fact, rule 8, what is the heading of rule 8? Action to avoid collision. There it doesn't separate out between giveaway and stand on. Whereas here, rule 16 talks of giveaway and 17 talks of stand on. So he is separating the two and he says, giveaway vessel shall take early and substantial action to keep well clear. Because in case he doesn't take early and substantial action, he is now going to talk of the stand on vessel which needs to take action in case giveaway vessel does not take action. So that's the importance of rule 16. Emphasizing that you need to take early and substantial action to keep well clear. That is one part. And the other part of this being for stand on, which is not 16, which is rule 17. Right? Also remember it says if circumstances of the case admit, something like that. What does it say? Exact words.
So far as possible.
Now so far as possible does not mean the giveaway vessel can say no, it is not possible for me to take action, so I will not take action. That's not the interpretation, right? You are giveaway, you continue to remain the giveaway vessel. If you cannot take early and substantial action, you are still expected to take some action as a giveaway vessel. And if the stand-on vessel feels that it is not readily, it is not sufficient or whatever, that we talk of in rule 17, if the stand-on vessel is not very happy with the action of the giveaway vessel, then the stand-on vessel will take action as per those rules, right? So don't look at rule 16 in singularity. It should be looked at in terms of rule 8 first, which is action by giveaway vessel. And also remember 16 is followed by 17, action by stand-on vessel. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any questions on this? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Nothing? Okay then, thank you very much. We'll go on to the next rule shortly.